Canvas is a learning management system used by both K-12 and higher education schools. This video is a speed run to see how fast I can build a higher education sample course in only 15 minutes. For this speed run, I have just a few rules. First, I'm allowed to use tools in addition to Canvas to help me build graphics and things like that. I'll go over these tools and tell you what I'm using as I go through the process. Second rule, I'm allowed to use outside resources to provide content that I'm putting in Canvas. I already have a sample syllabus that I found online. Thanks so much, Pennsylvania Department of Education, for posting your sample syllabus. I've looked over the syllabus just to make sure it has the content I need, but I definitely don't know what the content is in great detail. You'll see me looking through the syllabus throughout the speed run. The final rule is I will only build as much as I can in 15 minutes. This means I likely won't be able to build a full course, but I should be able to get a pretty good head start. I should also mention, I'm going to be moving much faster than I usually do when I build a Canvas course. Normally, I take time to think out the color scheme, some of the details on the images and the graphics. This time, I'm going to be moving as fast as I can. With all that said, let's get started. All right, so really quickly, once I started, I learned that I am not quite as proficient as I thought I was. I was moving pretty fast, faster than I usually do, but it was, I was finding myself caught up on typing and tabs and things like that. So the first thing I'm doing is going through this course settings. I added a course card. I'm now adjusting my navigation so that I can make it really easy for students to navigate. This is all course setup stuff. It mostly has to do with how can I make a better experience for students? What are the major hiccups that I might create if I don't do these things? And that's actually what I'm doing now too, is a little more course setup. I'm adding in some assignment groups to match up with my syllabus. If you do not set up these assignment groups at the beginning, you can really set your students up for some pain, because especially if you have weighted grades, because then you go in and add those weights at the end and it totally adjusts what their grade was prior to the that adjustment. So you need to set those up at the very beginning. So I got those set up. Next thing I do is I go in and I add a syllabus. In this case, I just uploaded the PDF and put it in the put it in there. I did make it so that it would display in line, so it pops open when they open the page. They don't have to download it. They can just look at it right in Canvas. My preferred method is actually to build the syllabus in Canvas, but because of time, I just rushed through it. Now I'm going through and building some framework for the modules. Everything that I'm doing, I kind of intentionally prioritize the order that I create things. And I would recommend, if the first things I did, those were the things that if you don't do, they're absolutely critical. Those are some of the more important steps. And then, I kind of prioritize it from there. I may get a little bit out of order and some of this stuff goes different ways, but building some structure for your modules kind of sets you up for success, because you can visually get an idea of how your course will be structured. I put three modules in here just to get started. I come back to them later. Now I'm building a homepage. I went ahead and got a free image from pexels.com that's related to the course itself. I went and got an ECG machine here. Now, in this case, yeah, a lot of times you can't find an image that's going to work exactly for you, so you have to pull it into some image editing software. I'm using Photoshop and Illustrator. Honestly, I could have just used Photoshop. I'm not a good Photoshop user, so just be aware of that. Some of this stuff that I'm doing isn't really the best practice. And what I usually try to do is learn whatever tool or whatever I need to do. And I have done some stuff in Photoshop, but I just work in Illustrator so much more. I'm so much more comfortable with it. The steps I'm doing right now in Photoshop, I can't do in Illustrator. I'm filling in space and I want it to match my other photo so that it looks really uniform and looks good. And you can't necessarily do that in Photoshop or in Illustrator really well. So I'm setting this up in Photoshop, but then I pull it out of Photoshop and go and put it in Illustrator, which is honestly probably the wrong way to do it, but it would have taken me like 5 minutes to go look it up in Photoshop. I'm just not as proficient. So I pulled it into Illustrator and it took me longer to do this banner than I'd hoped. And it ended up being not a very pretty banner anyway, but it works. For, you know, it took me 3 minutes, which is way faster than I normally create a banner. Usually I'll spend an hour or two creating banners, and more than likely I'll create two or three banners for a course when I design a course, just because my first idea isn't always my best idea. So I get to play with a few different ideas. I get to play with the colors a little bit. I usually, like I said, spend a lot more time in a course setting it up and putting in the details, but in this case, time was not on my side. Now, I had a little bit of trouble with the editing tool. If you are not familiar though, these tools are kind of more advanced, they take a little more training to use. I've been using them for a few years now, the Adobe tools. But there's also other tools. You can even build a banner in PowerPoint. You can build a banner in, there's a tool out there called Canva, canva.com. It's a fantastic tool. Tons of teachers use it. In fact, you can get a free premium account if you if you're in K-12. So you get extra access to things and you don't have to pay for it. But the base account is always free. Anyway, now I'm back in Canvas. I'm adding my content to my homepage. There's three pieces of content I add here, and I recommend everybody do the same. The first one is a title. My banner checks that box. And now I'm adding some quick links, basically areas of the course or specific details that students are gonna need to access regularly. I'm dividing this up into chunks so that visually students can really easily identify the different areas. But I have a title, I have the quick links, and then this third piece that I just added was a little bit of detail about the course. Sometimes that could include like your office hours or contact info, whatever students might need to see regularly on that front page. That's sometimes helpful to add. Just adding in some white space now. And I felt pretty good about this homepage, at least good enough that I had to move on. I spent too much time on it, honestly, for the 15 minutes that I was allotted here. Now I go back through my home, my modules, and I wanted to add an instructor page because I put that instructor link on the homepage. So I'm building out this instructor page, adding some images, this is where an instructor page is usually where you go and add in like contact information, when to contact, best method of contact, where your office is, office hours, all that kind of stuff. It's nice to have this for students to jump back to. It is probably in your syllabus, but having a page right there that isolates contact information makes it easier for students to find. Now, you'll notice I jumped into the code a little bit. You do not ever have to get into code to build anything in Canvas. The only reason I did is knowing a little bit of code. So let me take a step back. All Canvas web pages, essentially when I create a Canvas web page here, it's writing the code for me. That's what this Canvas editor does. So knowing a little bit of code allows me to kind of hack the system and be able to make adjustments. Those are web development tools, so HTML, CSS. You do not have to be proficient or really proficient to use them. It's really not too bad. But if it does scare you, I mean, take comfort in the fact that you don't have to know any web development. Now here again, I'm kind of just going through filling in content. That's what's going on. I'm moving pretty quick, but I'm just filling in placeholders so I can move on to the next page. And in a real world scenario, I would either spend time building it or I just put a placeholder and then come back to it later. Now what's going on? I'm adding in details of my modules. I have less than 5 minutes left at this point and I was really rushing, but I needed to add in more details on my modules. So I was pushing to get that stuff done. And as I went through, a couple of things that I did. One, I added some assignments in that first module, that welcome module. I always like to put low stakes assignments in there so that when students are first getting started with the course, they have an opportunity to practice using Canvas. They can submit courses and content without really having to have a really high stakes in as far as, you know, it's not a really high stakes environment. It's basically a participation assignment. So I do that in the first week. And then down below, I'm just adding in notes and details of what I would include in those weeks. Normally, if your modules are really long, I recommend kind of creating some organization, some structure, maybe text headers, indenting things a little bit, making it more visually easy to read. And that's kind of what I normally do. But in this case, if your modules are as small as mine with only two or three items in there, you don't really have to do that. Now, at this point, I realized I hadn't set up my homepage. So I go in, set up my homepage. I also, at this point, decide to go in and add links because before it was just text placeholders. These links here, oftentimes I'll use buttons, but for the sake of time, and by buttons, I mean images that I turn into links so that they stand out. But in this case, I just kind of was moving fast. At this point, I jump into the Canvas guide. So if you're not familiar with the Canvas guides, there are details on how to do every little thing in Canvas. It's made by Instructure, the company that makes Canvas. They're awesome. I absolutely love the guides. I keep up to date on all of the feature changes and stuff through the guides. It's really helpful. Now, as this final task, I had a minute and a half left, and I wanted to show how to create instructions. And there's three things that I include on these instructions for this assignment here. First thing, and I'm writing it now, is the summary. So you write just a quick summary of what the assignment is about, why are you doing it. Second thing that you'll see me do, I add in explicit step-by-step instructions. So I'm going through those details, adding in instructions, step-by-step, how to do this. And then the third thing that I always like to include, but I didn't get to here because of time, is I like to provide support. So if you are asking them to write an essay with APA formatting, then include a guide, link out to the guide for APA formatting. So it's right there. They don't have to go look it up. There's a lot of good information on the internet. There's also a lot of bad information. So make sure you're pointing them to, this prevents them from finding bad info on their own. Anyway, it was at this point that I realized, I looked at the timer and I was like, oh man, I am not going to be done, but it was tough. It was tough, but it was fun. Well, I didn't get it done, but I did my very best. I know that was a whirlwind of creation there, and if you were trying to follow along, it was probably really tough. So I'm going to include a lot of links down in the description to various Canvas guides that walk through some of the stuff that I did. If you have any questions, you can feel free to post them in the comments or whatever, and we can talk a little bit more about them there as well. But thanks for watching. I had a lot of fun going through and building the course super fast. I hope you have a fantastic day. Thanks. Bye.